What's up, big dog in the house? Just making a little small video. People asked me to make another cooking video. And I am. And this is all what I got here. All my ingredients. And I'm gonna make chicken stew with white rice and chickpeas. And welcome to the big dog.
That's all the ingredients that I showed in the first place. So I'm gonna start adding stuff to the stew. The yellow and stuff, sazon.
All those. Just going on. Let's say, Oh, you don't use measuring cups or measuring spoons. I don't. That's how I was taught. That's how my mother was taught. That's how my grandmother was taught. So, I've done it a billion times. And it's just instinct. You know, I'm not going to sit here and tell you, take a teaspoon of this, take a teaspoon of that. No. You know, you figure it out. Y'all know how to cook. This is chicken broth. And it comes in cubes. So if you can see it there. And instead of buying the chicken broth, and sometimes you don't use it all and it spoils or whatever, you know. It comes in a cube. So it's perfect. Chicken broth. Throw that in there. Okay, add some olives.
Olives out here.
Whatever, how many olives you want? How you like them? I really don't like olives too much. I like it because it makes the food taste good. But I'm not. When I was a kid, I used to eat them. It's funny, and now I can't. I don't know what it is. Put a couple of olives in there. All my products are Goya. And throw in a little adobo. Adobo is just a seasoning. You can use it in chicken. You can use it in whatever you want. Don't use too much because it's a little salty. I do it by instinct, you know. So this may be, I don't know, for y'all, 2 spoons. You know, I have potatoes to throw in there. You've seen it. I have mixed vegetables. And I got some garbanzo beans. Garbanzo in Spanish, chickpeas in English. But bam, learn something new every day, huh? Got the garlic, got some chopped onions, I have some jalapeno chopped there, and I have some peppers chopped there. Okay, so I want you to see how it looks. Kind of sucks. So yeah, so I'm cooking this, I'm gonna do a little rant. So I had people ask me, I need measurements, I need this, I need that. Like I said, I don't do measurements. But do you see this? Do you see this ring right there? After a while, that mark stays, that's where you put in the water. And that's where my measuring line is that. So, I put water up to the line, and then I boil it, make a boil, and I throw in I throw in the rice until it makes like a little mountain. And when that little mountain comes out the water, that's perfect. And I'll show you that in a little bit. Now I'm just letting, so I have
chicken thighs.
Boom, I washed it all up. Now I'm just gonna add it up in here. I'll let that cook for a little bit. Make it cook. I hope you cook it completely. And then after it's cooked, you can throw in your potatoes, your vegetables, whatever, your garlics, whatever else. Whatever you're gonna throw in there. You can throw whatever you want. Sausages. Whatever it is, up to you. It's your, you know. I'm throwing in all this because my refrigerator, my Dominic, I think it was Dominic, messed up. So now I got this little teeny tiny refrigerator there, and I'll show you that in a little bit. So, like I was saying, guys, this is what I do. I hope you can see the ring. That's my measurement. So my water is boiling. Now I'm gonna add the rice. I finished washing the rice. And I'm adding the rice now. Remember I was telling y'all about that little mountain? I don't know if y'all can see it. Once that little mountain is like that, more or less is the right serving of rice. So I have maybe 4 cups of rice, or 3.5 cups of rice, more or less. So that's my measuring. Once that pop up like that, I know I'm good, because once I stir it, everything is down below the water line. It's maybe that much, but that's how I do it. No measuring cups. That's how I saw my grandmother do it. That's how I saw my mom do it. And that's how they showed me. So now I wait till the rice start drying and stir it up a couple times so it won't be sticky. Like I said before in the other video, we'll get that sticky rice. So my rice is getting there. The water evaporating. Doing the little shakedown. That looks pretty. Sure does look pretty. Got Foxy Lady. She's ready for the food. Are you ready for the food? Oh, are you camera shy? Huh? Hey, baby. Hey. Hey. That's a baby. Yeah. You waiting for the food? Oh, yes. Hey, I'm waiting for the food. Oh, you gonna get him? Who are you gonna get? Oh, was he protecting me? He was. Yeah, so I decided to throw in the chickpeas in here too. It's all the same thing. Okay, look at how beautiful that looks. So I got garlic, I have jalapeno peppers, black green peppers, I have onions, olives, seasoning, whatever seasoning you want to put in, you know, that's how it looks. How it looks. I think that looks beautiful.
longer you have this simmering, the nicer the chicken starts breaking up. And that's what you want. You want the chicken to break up a little. Well, that's how I like it. See the piece of chicken? Yeah. See? That's what you want. I'll let this thing in high heat for a little while more. Let that chicken break up. And the rice is in there. So, that's it, guys. Another Big Dog Kitchen Hour. Pretty soon I'll show you the results. See you back in
well,
a few.
Well, guys, that thing is done. Let's get some rice in here. Foxy. The rice. Someone has hunger pains.
That's how it look like, guys. Tell me that doesn't look good.
All right, now.
So even when I cook, even the animals. Oh, that's a big animal over there.
My first time I've been out of the RV today. Thank you, Felix.
Okie dokie. CBK is feeling under the weather for a couple days.
So. Old Phil is taking good care of me.
Yeah, I try.
I've been sicker, but I don't remember when.
How's the food?
Delicious. Come here, Rocket. Rocket! Come here. Chicken approved.
All right, now it's been another amazing day here at the Big Dog's Kitchen. Peace out. See you next time. Peace.